Yeah, Jeremy, we tracked him down at the State of the City address at the Montebello Rec Center. He said this is a multi-layered investigation. They're trying to figure out how so many people got hurt and whether they were hit with actual bullets. He told us 4 of the 5 people are physically doing okay. The 5th person, as of earlier today, is still in the hospital, according to the chief.
We are very concerned about anybody that was injured as a result of this incident.
The Denver police chief says there are several investigators looking at training, policy, and the decision 3 officers made to fire their weapons at a man with a gun in downtown Denver Sunday morning.
We will review those internally to see if the tactics and the training utilized is appropriate.
In addition to the suspect, 3 women and 2 men suffered non-life-threatening injuries. The department is trying to figure out what struck each of them.
Is this shrapnel? Is this debris? Is it direct fire? Is it indirect fire? And we want to, you know, certainly take a look at all of those.
The problem solvers obtained arrest records showing police accused Jordan Waddy of pointing a firearm at them. Our investigation also found he has a violent criminal history, once serving time in the youthful offender system for his role in an aggravated attempted marijuana robbery that ended with someone getting killed when Waddy was a teen. Sunday's arrest affidavit shows Waddy was involved in an altercation and appeared to have a gun in his waistband. He was walking away from officers as they approached.
How the officers engaged with him becomes critically important. Now, at the point when he pulls the gun and he starts pointing it, then your options are much more limited.
Criminal justice expert Dennis Kenny says looking at training and decision making will be an important part of the investigation. He says the goal is to create a situation where deciding to shoot is not a split second decision.
They need to ask themselves, were there better ways that we could have approached the suspect? That when we, in the event that it did turn into a shoot, don't shoot decision, that we had greater control of the environment. In some situations, you could conclude not shooting creates greater risk for the public than shooting.
Now, the chief says the Office of the Independent Monitor has been involved since the very beginning of this. By Wednesday, they hope to have more critical interviews completed so they can give us more information. They do have body camera footage, and they also are reviewing halo camera footage. I'm Lori Jane Gliha, Fox 31.